In today's episode, let's look into easy ways to grow 10 vegetables from veggies and scraps from your kitchen. It's a quick video, like about 1 minute for each veggie with results. Please watch it till the end. Let's start with onions. Onions are actually grown from seeds to get the bulbs. One seed generally gives one bulb. However, if you want to harvest fresh organic spring onions, you can take some onions from your kitchen and plant them either directly into the soil or even in water. If you grow them in soil, make sure you have at least 30 to 40% compost in soil. And also, you need to water only if the topsoil is fully dry. If you grow in water, you need to change water every week. You can harvest fresh spring onions after 20 to 30 days. The number of plants a single onion bulb can produce will vary from 1 to 6. In our case, you can see one bulb has produced 7 or 8 plants and they're independent bulbs. For larger size bulbs, you can separate these and plant them independently. Onions need full direct sunlight of at least 4 to 6 hours. Let's grow mint. Do not throw away mint stems into the bin. Just plant them back in soil or in any container to get an unlimited supply of mint leaves. You only require a container with a well-draining soil and some compost to grow mint. Every time you plant the stems, add a handful of compost like decomposed cow dung or even vermicompost once, and that's sufficient till the harvest. Water them only if the soil is dry. Mint can be grown in bright, indirect sunlight or filtered light under a green shade net. Let's grow chili peppers. It's not really difficult to grow chilies from chilies. Take a mature chili pot from your kitchen. Do not try this on immature or green pots because the germination rate is lower. Extract the seeds by splitting this pod. Take a shallow container or even seed trays if you have. The soil should be full of compost, like about 30 to 40% vermicompost or decomposed cow dung or both. Just sprinkle the seeds with some spacing and add a thin layer of soil or compost on top of this. Water them every other day. They start sprouting within a week. Once they reach about 4 inches, you can choose the best ones and plant them in larger containers, like about 8 to 12 inch containers, which are generally sufficient for chili peppers. You need full direct sunlight of around 4 to 6 hours minimum to grow chili peppers. Now let's grow garlic. Garlic can be easily rooted from a single clove. Each clove will produce a new plant. Take some good quality garlic from your kitchen or storeroom and separate its cloves gently. Plant them in any container of your choice with a good amount of compost in soil. They should start germinating within a week. If you planted them in smaller containers, you can transplant them in larger containers with a loose, well-draining soil. Garlic needs full direct sunlight of at least 4 to 6 hours or can even be grown in filtered light under a green shade net. Now let's grow pineapple. Never throw away the pineapple tops, especially if they look fresh and healthy. You can easily grow a pineapple tree from it. Make sure you strip few leaves at the bottom to expose the white portion. You can leave it for a day or two to form the callus and then you can either plant it directly in loose well-draining soil or first root it in a glass of water. If you grow in water, you need to change the water every week. You can even drop a quarter tablet of aspirin 350 mg tablet into this water every time you change it. This helps in faster and healthy rooting by boosting the plant's immune response. You can watch a detailed episode on the benefits of aspirin in gardening from a link in the description below. Well, once the rooting starts, you can transfer them into a larger container of at least 12 inches with a good amount of compost in it. Now let's grow capsicum or bell pepper. You have to use a mature pod like red or yellow and not the immature green capsicum for better germination results. Just extract the seeds by cutting this pod and then plant them in a soil with good amount of compost. They start germinating within a week. Once they grow to about 4 inches, you can perform thinning of seedlings and choose the best ones to grow and then transplant them in independent containers. Let's grow coriander or cilantro. This can be easily grown from seeds. To get the best harvest, you need to first split the seeds by scraping them in sandpaper or stuff like that. Remember, each coriander seed is technically a fruit containing two seeds in it. Hence, splitting will produce more plants. Do not use any heavy object or too much pressure to split them. They can get damaged and may not germinate. Plant them in any container, preferably in shallow containers, and once they germinate and produce the first set of leaves, keep them in full direct sunlight, else they can become too thin and leggy. Water them daily or alternate days depending on the climate. You can harvest cilantro multiple times by leaving an inch of the stem while harvesting, and this method regrows cilantro again and again. Let's grow potatoes. Yes, you can grow potatoes from grocery bought potatoes or seed potatoes purchased from the garden store. You can keep the potato for pre-sprouting, that's called chitting a potato. You keep them for 15 days in a carton box in a dark place. Once it sprouts, plant it deeply in a loose soil in a large container of at least 15 inch depth and diameter. Once it starts growing shoots, keep on adding soil on top to make room for more tubers growing inside. Once the potato flowering starts, you can pinch or snip it off to divert the energy to potato tuber formation rather than seed formation. You can harvest new or baby potatoes after 70 days and mature storage potatoes after 90 to 120 days. Let's grow ginger and turmeric. The process is same for both these rhizomes. You can soak them for 12 hours in water for faster germination. Plant them in smaller containers first for pre-sprouting, or directly plant them in larger containers. Make sure potting soil has more than 50% compost in it, and it should be a loose, well-draining soil. You can watch a detailed episode on some of the best potting mix recipes from a link in the description below. Well, ginger and turmeric start germinating within a week. Make sure you keep them in full sunlight or filtered sunlight under a green shade net. Water them once the soil is dry. You can add a handful of compost once every 15 days. You can harvest them once the plant starts to wilt and becomes yellow. Let's grow tomatoes. Yes, you can easily grow tomatoes from tomatoes. Just slice them into multiple pieces of about half a centimeter thickness and then plant them into a compost-rich potting soil. You should see the little ones germinating within a week. Now you can perform thinning of seedlings, where you choose only the best ones and discard the weaker ones. Transplant them into little larger containers at this stage. Though growing tomatoes looks really easy, you need to apply some tricks and procedures to get the best harvest, starting from its early growth phase, like what fertilizer to use, supports to use, removing tomato suckers, and many tricks that makes tomatoes healthier with a better yield. Please watch my episode on 10 tricks to grow lots of tomatoes from a link at this end screen here. Please like, share, and comment below with your queries and feedback. Happy gardening!